Dear friends, dear class, today we'll start a new module, module 4, chapter 1, class 1, engineering materials. I am Manjunatha E, assistant professor, BITM, Ballari, mechanical engineering department. Let's start with the content. In content, introduction to engineering materials, history of the engineering materials, the classification of the engineering materials, ferrous and ferrous alloy, non-ferrous and non-ferrous alloy. In tomorrow class, we'll discuss about ceramic, polymers and smart materials. Let's start with introduction to engineering materials. Materials. What are materials? Materials are stuff. Real stuff. Now, you hold a pen, it is made up of some material. You hold a glass, it is also made up of some material. You hold anything, it is always made up of some material. Do they have properties? Yes, do they have? Yes, they have properties. Do we call them as engineering materials? Can we call a clay, a pot, a made up of a clay, an engineering material? Maybe, may not be. But engineering materials are refers to a group of materials that are used in construction of a building, a bridge, a dam, or any material. They should be able to withstand applied load without breaking and without excessive deflection. History of the engineering materials. Man, the Homo sapiens, if you look at the Homo sapiens history of 80,000 years ago, Homo sapiens means wise man. You look at our history, we used stones. Why we use stones? To hunt. After the Stone Age, for somewhere in 3,000 years ago, I don't know exactly, but you can say somewhere in 3,000 years ago, we come to the Bronze Age, the one that is used in China. The early known recording we can able to come in China. So what is the use of bronze, what kind of things we use to make from bronze means, not only the tools to hunt, but also we use the tools for utensils, for decorative purpose, for other things. In the 19th century, or I can say in the early 18th century, we have come to the steel age. Steel is very important. With the steel only, with the invention of steel, you can say, we have built the machines, the engine, all the things the modern world, how can we have an industrial revolution, the first industrial revolution, without steam engine? And steam engine is made up of steel. So how can we have an industrial revolution, or you can say, how can you build an engine without steel? So steel is the one which led to the steam engine. The steam engine led to the industrial revolution. After the steel age, we come to the polymer age. Look at thousands of chemicals. The scientists or chemists developed in the 19th century. There are more than 100,000 chemicals we have developed less than 100 years. One of the byproduct or a product of the chemical revolution is, or you can say the chemical age is polymer age. When you brush your teeth, when you carry a water bottle or a bag, or when you wear the cloth that we do use today, the textile, it is not made up of pure textile, it has some polymer in it. So all things are made up of polymer. That's the reason why we call it as polymer age. After polymer age, we have semiconductor ages there. All electronic components are made up of semiconductor material. How can you have processor without semiconductor? After the semiconductor age, now we having an age is there. The age is smart material. What are smart material? This material, unlike the material that we used for thousands of years, they don't keep quiet. They interact with the environment. You change the environment, the behavior of the material also changes. That means these material react to the external stimulus that is provided. Example for a smart material naturally occurring is skin. We'll discuss the smart material, we'll discuss when we are discussing the smart material in the coming classes. Classification of material. Classification of materials, the materials can be classified into metals and non-metals. Under metals we have ferrous metals and non-ferrous. Under non-metals we have plastics. Under plastic we have thermoplastic, thermoset, elastomer. Elastomer, the non-technical word is rubber. Ceramics. In ceramics we have glasses and crystalline ceramics. Composite. Under composite we have metal matrix composite, polymer matrix composite, ceramic matrix composite. Ferrous material. The word ferrous is a Latin word which means iron. You can see in this diagram the color. Cast iron is a combination of two materials. Two materials are very important, need to remember. That is, one is cast iron. In cast iron, when we have pig iron is there, or generally you can use the word iron. Second one is carbon. The percentage of carbon should be more than 2% and 2-4%. For practical application, we limit to 2-4%. But theoretically, in an iron carbon diagram, it can go up to 6.7%. What if we go above 6.7%? Simply, it is not a cast iron alloy. Simply, the iron reject the carbon when you try to mix the two materials. And if it is less than 2%, then it is not called as cast iron. It is called as simply steel. So the percentage of carbon determines whether it is cast iron, steel, like that. What are the advantages of cast iron? Means good casting properties. It is available in large quantities, hence produced in mass scale. Complex shape and size can be done without machining operation. Great, I can say excellent compressive strength. Good machinability. Gray cast iron. Advantages of cast iron. Low notch sensitivity, low stress concentration, low cost. Durability, resistance to deformation. Disadvantages: prone to rusting. All the ferrous materials, you take any ferrous material, generally they are prone to rusting. Poor tensile strength, poor impact load, poor impact resistance. Generally, you know, when you apply a sudden load on a material, then cast iron will fail. Poor machinability. High weight to strength ratio. This is one of the things. High weight to strength ratio. During the early part of the automobile revolution, all the engines, engine cylinder, most of the components are made up of cast iron, but nowadays they are slowly replaced by aluminium. The reason why they are slowly replaced by aluminium is low in weight compared to cast iron, Since low in weight means the total weight of the vehicle will be reduced. If the total vehicle weight is reduced, then less fuel consumption. Still, where you can able to find most of the components, if not all the components, are made up of cast iron is tractor. Tractor is one where you can able to find most of the components, if not all, are made up of cast iron. The reason in tractor they are made up of cast iron and they are not replaced with aluminium is durability. Ability to withstand extreme condition. Tractor, where we use tractor? In farming. So they have to withstand that service where aluminium may not able to withstand it. So tractor is one where most of the components still they are made up of cast iron. Application of cast iron. They are used for making pipes to carry suitable fluids. It is used for making different machine components, all the machine foundations. You take lathe, you take milling, you take drilling, you take planer, shaper. The foundation of all the machine tools is made up of cast iron. You can also find them in pot pans and utensils, anchoring of ships, etc. These are the few applications. You can able to find many more applications. Types of cast iron. Grey cast iron, white cast iron, ductile cast iron, malleable cast iron. These are cast iron alloys. Properties of cast iron or alloys means we are comparing cast iron, plain cast iron, that means cast iron means iron plus carbon, with cast iron alloy, iron plus carbon plus other elements may be magnesium, chromium, nickel, zinc, any metal. If you add those material, generally you'll be able to find increasing hardness, increasing toughness, increasing ductility and increase in elasticity. Hardness means ability of the material to resist indentation, toughness means to absorb energy, ductility means torn into wires, and elasticity means return to its original shape, original dimension when the load is removed. So all these properties are improved when we add the third element. The third element, as we know, this group of alloy cast iron consists of high silicon, high chromium and high nickel cast iron. They are often used in valves, pumps, bodies, turbocharger, housing, manifold, compressor parts, several other industrial equipment. Plain carbon steel. A plain carbon steel, or simply a steel, is a combination of two materials, iron plus carbon. And there are minute impurities are there, manganese, silica, phosphorus, sulfur, but small in quantity, negligible. And they will not change any properties. Two elements are very important. One is iron, second one is carbon. This is a classification of steel, what we do. Steel means alloy steel, low alloy steel, high alloy steel, low carbon steel, medium carbon steel, high carbon steel. We'll discuss one by one. Classification of plain carbon steel. Plain carbon steel means low carbon steel, medium carbon steel, high carbon steel. The percentage of here in all these three, percentage of carbon plays an important role. For low carbon steel, the percentage of carbon varies from 0.1% to 0.7%. For medium carbon steel, 0.7% to 1.6%. For low carbon steel, the percentage varies from, low carbon steel, the percentage of carbon varies from 0.01% to 0.2%. For as for medium carbon steel, the percentage of carbon varies from 0.2% to 0.8%. For high carbon steel, the percentage varies from 0.8% to 1.6%. Theoretically, we can go up to 2%, but practically 1.6% where we stop for high carbon steel. What are the properties of carbon steel? Means highly ductile material, good fatigue property, good creep property, good stiffness, good resilience. Advantages means high strength, high resilience, high toughness, fatigue, good fatigue property, good impact load, highly elastic material. Generally we say that steel is more elastic than a rubber. Limitations of plain carbon steel are poor damping properties. Suppose vibration, any part has a lot of vibration is there or vibrates a lot, then this material may not be used, may not be suitable, cannot be cast into complicated shapes, low wear resistance, expensive, or you can say costlier than cast iron. Application of plain carbon steel is, first one, low carbon steel applications are stamping, fan blade, rivets, nuts, bolts, wires, structural steels, grills, shafts. These are the application for low carbon steel. In the classification of steel, we have three steels were there: low carbon steel, medium carbon steel, high carbon steel. Low carbon steel, the percentage of carbon varies from 0.01% to 0.2%. For such kind of steel, the application is the first one. For medium carbon steel, the percentage of carbon varies from 0.2 to 0.8%. The application are gears, valves, crankshaft, camshaft, axles, screws, springs. For high carbon steel, the applications are, the percentage of carbon varies from 0.8% to 1.6%. Cutting tools, milling cutters, blades, drill bits, musical instruments, agriculture application, etc. Alloy steel. Alloy steel is a steel alloyed with other element. The other element varies from 1% to 50% by weight to improve the mechanical properties. Basically, there are two elements are there, iron plus carbon. The third element, if we add, we can group them into two, low alloy steel and high alloy steel. Alloy steels are made up of combining carbon steel with one or several alloying elements such as magnesium, silicon, nickel, titanium, copper, chromium and aluminium. These metals are added to produce specific properties that are not found in regular carbon steel. Properties of carbon steel. Following is a range of improved properties in alloy steel as compared to carbon steel. Strength, hardness, toughness, wear resistance, corrosion resistance, hardenability and hardness. To achieve some of these properties, we may also require heat treatment. What is heat treatment? Heat treatment is the process of heating and cooling a material above certain temperature. The temperature we known as recrystallization temperature. What is recrystallization temperature? It is a temperature in which the new grains are formed. This whole topic is there about heat treatment. But we are not going into that. Advantages of alloy steel means great hardenability, less distortion and cracking, great stress relief at given hardness, less grain growth, high elastic ratio and endurance strength, greater high temperature strength, better machinability at high hardness, greater ductility at high strength. These are the advantages. Limitations means cannot be cast into complicated shapes, poor damping properties, costlier or expensive than plain steel or carbon steel. Application of alloy steel. It is used in building and construction industry. Alloy steels are used for very large modern structure such as airports, bridges, skyscrapers and stadium in the form of steel skeleton. Alloy steel provide the required high strength to support such large structures. Application of alloy steel, aircraft engine parts, heat exchanger, sanitary fittings, combustion chamber, furnace parts, gas burner, valves, pumps, surgical instrument, razor blades, turbine. These are the few applications of alloy steel. There are plenty of applications are there. I just named few. Non-ferrous materials. Non-ferrous material include aluminium, copper, lead, zinc and tin, as well as precious materials like gold and silver. The main advantages of ferrous material is malleability. Look, the example of gold. How, you know, we can able to hammer and make into very thin sheet. They also have no iron content, giving them high resistance to rust and corrosion, making them ideal for gutters, liquid pipes, roofing, outdoor signs. Lastly, they are non-magnetic, which is important for many electronic and wire applications. Name a few. The reason why the non-ferrous materials become such a popular is corrosion resistance, light in weight, non-magnetic. Sometimes non-magnetic is also a very important one for electronic and wire applications. These are name, you can say, these are the very few. This is one of the reasons why non-ferrous becomes highly popular. Aluminium and aluminium alloy. Aluminium is light in weight, soft and low weight. Aluminium is easily casted, forged, machined and welded. It is not suitable for high temperature environment. Why it is not suitable for high temperature environment is aluminium melting temperature is only 660 degrees Celsius. That's the reason why. Because aluminium is lightweight, it is good choice for manufacturing of aircraft and food cans. Back in the 19th century, aluminium was the choice for all the aircraft that we can able to see. Back in the 21st century, most of the aluminium now is replaced by carbon fiber. Aluminium is also used for casting piston, railways, cars and kitchen utensils. Even though the carbon fiber is replacing aluminium, but still there is a lot of research is going on aluminium. Let's see. Application of aluminium alloy. Aluminium alloys are widely used in aeronautical application. What way? Even today you can able to find that aluminium is used in aeronautical application. And aluminium nowadays also used in automobile industry. The reason why they are used in automobile industry is light in weight. Aluminium is one of the lightest material that is there. If the material is light, then the fuel consumption is low. And the performance of the overall, whether it's an automobile or a aircraft, is good. Heavier the vehicle, the poor the performance. Lighter the vehicle, the better the performance. So the performance. Other application is electrical conductors, household, consumer items, marine applications, windows, sporting equipments. These are the application of aluminium alloy. Next, copper. I can see copper, a symbol SCU is there. Melting point is 1083 degrees Celsius. Properties of copper means the color is reddish, metallic metal and is ductile. It is easily transferred mechanically or by hand. Compactability. Characteristic mean light in weight, low thermal momentum. Alloys of copper. copper plus zinc, brass, copper plus tin, bronze. These are the two things that are there for our syllabus. So we'll discuss only about two. One is the brass, second one is the bronze. First we'll discuss brass. Brass is an alloy of copper and zinc. Zinc and copper can be varied to create a range of brasses with varying properties. They are used for decoration of bright gold-like appearance for application where low friction is required, such as locks, gears, and bearings. Brass is often used in situations where it is important that spark does not be struck, as in fittings, tools, around explosive gases. Type of brasses, we have alpha brasses and alpha beta brasses. Properties of brasses means excellent machinability, good strength, as you can see the numbers, good corrosion resistance, conductivity, good conductivity, thermal and electrical, non-sparking, attractive color, strength at cryogenic temperature, even at very low temperature. It has a lot of strength is there. One of the things about steel is when it goes below minus 10 degrees Celsius, in the olden times, the steel used to be transformed into glass-like temperature. You can say glass transition temperature, where the steel act as a glass. You mean, what do you mean by glass? Now, if you drop the glass, it will be shattered into pieces. Similarly, at minus 20 degrees Celsius or minus 30 degrees Celsius, you drop a steel, example mild steel, it can be shattered like glass. There is no such problem for brasses, means it can able to stand that cryogenic temperature, recyclable. No loss of properties at a temperature up to 200 degrees Celsius. Good impact resistance, toughness. Application means these are the applications the brasses are often used. Brasses offer freedom from corrosion, fit tolerance in machining, smooth operation of moving parts, long trouble-free life without maintenance or replacement. You can see these diagrams where the brass is used. You can see furthermore diagrams where the brass is used. Door sets, electrical components. You can see the electrical components are also made up of brasses. Switches, plugs, industrial fuse gears, these are the products which are made up of brasses. You can see in the diagram, the decorative and purposes. The decorative purpose, you can see the puja items in the above diagram and the gods that are made in the below diagram. For that purpose, we also use brasses. Plumbing, you can see the plumbing equipment also made up of brasses. You can see Paris church is there, it is the entire outer structure is made up of brass. Brass, you can see these are the various other application of brasses. Hinges, latches, door fittings, glass fittings, tower bolts. These are furthermore applications of brasses. Foil, strips, pipes, sheets, brass, wires. Advantages. Super color and texture, will accept mirror like polish, will not corrode, can be manufactured as rod, profile, tubes, plate, sheet, foils and wires, good strength and durability, easily processed by casting, extrusion, rolling, drawing and hot stamping, excellent machining qualities, no degradation in sunlight, only plastics or polymers will degrade. I don't think the metals will degrade under sunlight. Will not soften at high temperature up to 200 degrees Celsius. Will not be brittle in sub-zero temperature down to minus 100 degrees Celsius. Disadvantages. Brasses require good deal of maintenance since it can be prone to blackish tarnish. You can see in this diagram. This is the disadvantage of brass doors. The doors can be scratched or dented when it gives bad look. Brasses doors are suitable only for interior. This is one of the case studies that is taken to show the disadvantages of a brass. Bronze. Bronze is an alloy of copper and tin, 88% copper, 12% tin. Brass usually is a golden hard brittle metal. Microstructure of brass is shown in this diagram. Advantages of brass means bronze means it's an alloy containing copper, but the addition of other material tin usually produces alloy much harder than plain carbon. Bronze metal fatigue better. Now, better fatigue properties. What is fatigue? The cyclic loads, compressive strength, tensile strength. When you apply cyclic load, you create a fatigue. So, it is good at fatigue. Conduct heat and electricity better than most steel, obviously. Obviously, copper is always better in conducting than steels. Corrosion resistance. This is one of the things we commonly find in non-ferrous material is they are corrosion resistant. They are not corrosion free. They will resist the corrosion for a very long time. But invariably they can also be corroded. Is any material is there which is non-corrosion resistance? If you know it, you can able to answer in the Google Classroom. Please let us know as what is your answer. There are few metals are there. Generally non-metals withstand very high temperature, obviously, since the melting temperature of copper is 1083 degrees Celsius, obviously it can withstand higher temperature than that of aluminium. Friction and wear, good friction and wear properties, good machinability. Generally copper alloys are easy to machine compared to steel. Weldability. Brazing and soldering. Both brazing and soldering can be done on a bronze. Disadvantages. Bronze are softer, weaker and more expensive than steel. Obviously. Here are a few of the applications of bronze. Bronze tiger in Mysore. Anybody who visited Mysore or want to visit Mysore. There is a Mysore Palace has 6 of these magnificent sculptures in and around Grand Mysore Palace. Bronze. You can see sculptures in China. The building there is there. There is a bronze coating glasses in a building. But the question is, why do they want to coat the buildings with bronze? You can able to Google it in the search and able to find out the answer. And please let me know the answer in the Google Classroom. You can see the furthermore buildings. You can see the elevator door, the window frame. Made up of bronze. You can see further the Supreme Court in New Zealand, the bronze tap. In a gallery, you can see the bathroom staircase where we use bronze. Here you can see the naming plates, they are made up of bronze. Here see a few more applications, the propeller, the door frame, the window frame, the sculptures, the pumps, the decorative elements, bearings. So this will complete the ferrous or non-ferrous materials. In tomorrow class, we'll start with non-metals. Basically, we'll start with ceramics, polymers, and smart materials. If you have any queries, questions, any doubts are there, please let us know. And we try to answer to your questions or queries. Thank you. Thank you very much. Oh, yeah.